bacteria, honey. There we go.
It's been a month since Josiah's been born, and we're starting to take him out more.
What are you doing?
Today, we're meeting my mom and Chris at the park in Portland. Chris said that he had a surprise for Jackson, so we're excited to see what it is.
Where are you guys going?
Well, it's a nice little postage stamp of a park.
Yeah, cute little place. Hey, Zach.
Hey, how's it going?
Good. Boy, Lila sure likes
the little playground. Stuff. Hey, Lila.
Oh, how's he doing?
He thinks he's hungry, but he's not. Aww. That's all you do.
So far, everything's good, healthy, and...
Everything's great.
That's good. This is the second time that I've met Josiah.
Zach and Tori came over once, and I did get a chance to meet Josiah, but, you know, I mean, at that age, he's just this little shriveled ball of flesh.
He's not shriveled.
He barely had his eyes open. I mean, you know, there's...
And you held him, but you didn't want to.
Yeah, I've just never been into babies. I feel uncomfortable, you know, holding or picking them up because, you know, they just seem so vulnerable, so fragile. Until they start speaking and I can communicate with them.
In interaction.
Yeah, it's just a lot more fun to interact that way. So, it's all a big learning experience.
Hey, Jackson, Chris has something very special for you, okay?
What's him?
All right,
hey,
Chris.
Hey, that's awesome.
Yeah, that's way cool. Are you stoked?
Do you like that bike?
Yeah.
You want to give it a try?
Yeah.
Jackson, here, you got to put your helmet on, though.
Oh, great.
Here.
Well, it's just like your scooter.
Yeah, this is a brand new thing.
Hey, Lila Ray. Come on, Lila.
Has he been on one of these yet?
A tricycle?
They've all been too big. Jackson, he's very stoic, very, like, no reaction. You won't know if you like something until you get him home alone to see how much he talks about it. But I think it was really nice that Chris found a bike that fits Jackson without having Jackson there. I'm impressed.
You know how to get on one of those? Okay, so put this foot on this pedal and then swing the other leg around. There you go. Here, step up there. There you go. Oh, yeah, you gotta get on the seat. Okay.
Now, can you reach him?
Now, you press this way to go, and then if you wanna stop, push back, and it'll stop. Okay? All right.
Jackson was just barely able to reach the pedals. It turned out that my block idea was a blockhead idea. It didn't work. When he went to put his feet on the pedal, they would flip and wouldn't end up in the right position for his feet.
You gotta push that
nice
down.
Nice to watch, honey. Oh, and then keep going,
just
Jay.
Just keep going forward.
There you
go.
You gotta push down, push down.
Now watch where you're going.
Well, push down that way, not behind you, otherwise it'll stop.
You might have just been trying out
the
brake.
There you go, and then watch where you're going. You gotta steer too.
Yeah, there you go.
Good job, Jay.
Good job, Jackson.
Is riding a bike easy or hard?
Riding a bike is easy peasy.
When it's on this side, this foot, push down. But then once it goes here, once it goes right here, stop pushing and only push on this foot. Okay? Right, left, right, left, right, left. There you go. Push down and forward.
There you go. There you go.
Chris, I think, is trying to find things to connect with the kids on. He's got the fish tank. He did the bike thing. So it's nice. Chris takes some interest in the kids and does fun things like that. So I think it was great.
Yeah, I've never taught a kid how to ride a bike before either. And I certainly don't remember when I learned.
You just keep moving forward. Keep going. Keep going. No backwards. Just keep going forward. All right.
There you go. Watch where you're going, Bill.
I was really happy that Jackson took to the bike. He struggled a little bit at first, and I was...
Well, he kept not knowing to go forward, how to go forward in the brakes.
Yeah, I kept hitting the brake, but in the end, it seemed like he liked it, like he enjoyed it.
Good job. Yeah,
Jackson,
awesome.
Good job starting that.
Yeah, we'll
hey,
have to
Jackson,
practice
Jackson,
that.
What do you tell Chris and Mimi?
Yeah.
You're welcome.
Wally!
Watch out, watch out, watch out.
Good job, babe.
You know, it's watching stuff like this where I regret that I never had kids. Aww. You know, I didn't have any of these moments.
Well, now you have these ones to share it with.
Well, Jackson, we're glad that you like the bike. Chris was so excited to give that to you.
Thank you, Chris, for my new bike.
Can I try it? Oh, my gosh. Here I go. Boo! Whoa!
Oh, my gosh. Gosh, knuckleheads.
You guys gonna be able to come and help us out for pumpkin season?
Yeah, we'll be here.
I should be able to show you your new bedroom. It should be framed. For framed, won't be able to sleep in
it. I don't think you guys are gonna let me in that house. That's what I like about your DW. You don't have to take your shoes off.
That's true. Cowboy Bob and his wife Jody. I just met Jody in recent years, you know, 10 years ago, but Bob I've known for 40 some odd years. We grew up together just south of San Francisco in a town called San Bruno. We were, I think, 14 or 15 years old, and we went to junior high together and high school together. And Bob and Jody, they're in town for a couple of days. He was on his way up to Northern California and kind of detoured through to come see us here at the farm.
What are you boys chatting about?
Minding our own business.
Hey, hey, hey.
We are going to go take a walk.
Oh, okay.
So only one condition. Okay. When you come back, you can't have a honey-do list.
Well, that's what we're working on. Don't talk about us while we're gone.
We might, just a little bit.
I met Jody maybe 7-8 years ago. You know, Bob and Matt were good friends, and they would come out for pumpkin season and stay on the farm. So we got to be good friends really quickly. She's a really neat person. Oh, yeah, this isn't getting much use these days.
Well, that has to be sad right there.
I know, it's probably weird for you guys coming to town and there's no...
No little kids.
No kids.
No little Jackson. Well, I bet he misses being here because he always loved to come and play on the farm.
You and Bob went up to see them, so you've seen their new place.
We saw their new place. They didn't have chickens at that time, but I think maybe they've gotten chickens by now.
So I've heard. Bob and Jody have known Zach and Tori for a long time, so they were aware, you know, that things were not super cohesive. I think they had hoped to see them, but it just, you know, every family has stuff. So the stars weren't aligned. It's hard, you know, I think blending families, you know, and Matt and I aren't married, but I still went all in because I planned to spend my life with Matt. And so I love those kids, like, seriously, like they were blood. And I don't really have any tools to fix this, and I have to let it run its course. It's his family.
It is his family. He's gonna have to figure out how to fix this.
You know, honestly, I remain really sad about the whole situation. I wish it had never happened. If we could go back in time, I know Matt and I would do things differently. I wish I knew how to move forward. I'm ready, and if I were to see an opportunity to fix it, I would be all over it. But the opportunity hasn't really come around that feels natural.